Before I get started, I want to share something real quick. This is just funny. I got a text this morning from a guy named Brock, who is a friend and who watches Monday Mindset, uses the tools. He was working from home today and watching last week's Monday Mindset, where we had Johnny Quinn, if you remember. If you haven't watched it, by the way, go watch that episode. Just pure gold from Johnny on an Olympian's mindset. But Brock texts me. He said, I'm working from home watching last week's Monday Mindset. My son comes over, so I pause it and ask him, which of these two do you think was in the Olympics? And his son answered, Kevin. So
I'm coming back on. Really?
Yeah.
And that made you feel really good.
And well, I have an Olympian's physique, maybe a speed walker. Maybe he thought I was a speed walker.
Oh, goodness. I feel for your wife, Megan, after that. You were probably probably going to be strutting around the house telling your boys and your wife.
Listen. That's right.
Yeah. Okay. That's well, right. Okay. Here we go. I'm getting off now. I'm sorry. You just, wow.
I love it. So, you know, I mentioned we're getting our house ready to sell. And what that really means is, you know, we're doing all the things that we should have done the last 7 years. I've been in this house 7 or 8 years. And so we're fixing up certain things, painting certain things, all the stuff that we should have already done that we just dealt with, that we just like, we'll get to that later. Or you just learn to deal with it and live with it. And now they become a stress. Right? Because we've put them off for 7 or 8 years. Now they are a stress. Now they're an issue. Now we have to try to get it done in a matter of a couple of weeks instead of the 7 or 8 years. And it's a reminder, and it's stuff that you know, again, we've lived with, but somebody else is going to want to fix, right? They're going to say, hey, that needs to be changed. Hey, that needs to be repaired, whatever it is. Except they're going to move in and learn to live with things too, and learn to just deal with things and work around things. And it's a reminder of me for, we do the same thing with our minds, right? There are unhealthy thoughts you've allowed to be in there. There are lies that you've believed, that you've just let take root. There are things that have just, that are impacting your mindset in an unhealthy way. And you know it, and you've known it for years. You've just never dealt with it. I'll get to that later. I'll worry about that tomorrow. I just learn to live with it. Yeah, maybe someday I'll get to that. But then someday hits, and you need that healthy mindset, right? You need that secure mindset. You need those strong beliefs. And in the moment, it's too late. Now it's stressful, right? Just like with our home, we kept putting, I'll do that tomorrow, I'll do that later. Well, now it's stressful, right? We should have had all this stuff done. It's too late. Right now we're rushing and we're stressing. The same thing can be true for us. We're going to get into situations. We're going to get into meetings and conversations and adversity and obstacles. And we're going to need that healthy mindset. We're going to need that strong mindset. We're going to need that useful mindset. And we're going to wish that we had done the work. We're going to say, man, I wish I would have taken care of this earlier. I wish I would have dealt with this lie earlier. I wish I would have worked on my mindset earlier. I wish I would have dealt with that lack of belief earlier, because now I need it. And now because I don't have it, it's holding me back. Now because I don't have it, I can't operate as I should be able to within this situation. I should have done the work earlier. I should have worked on my mindset earlier. We do the same thing with a lot of things, right? With our health, with relationships, with whatever it may be. I'll get to that later on. And then it's too late. And so I think the questions that we have to be considering today is like, what are the things that are holding back your mindset? What are the things that are impacting your mindset in a negative way that you've been delaying, that you've been putting off, that you've been avoiding, that you've been working around, that you've just simply been living with, that need to be addressed, that need to be repaired, that need to be fixed, that need to be torn out, that need to be replaced, so that you can have the mindset that you actually need to move forward on purpose, to unlock your potential? Right? What are the things in your mindset that you've just allowed to take root that aren't healthy? They aren't good, right? You've convinced yourself that you can work around them. You convinced yourself that it's all fine. It's no big deal, but you know it's not. And at some point it's going to come back to bite us. And I don't mean that to be negative, right? That's not how I operate. But I just know how life works. Adversity always hits. Adversity always hits. And what is your mindset going to be when that adversity hits, right? You don't want to get into that moment, oh, I knew this was going to hold me back. I knew this was going to trip me up. I knew this was going to take me out. I should have dealt with this. I should have worked on this. I should have fixed this. I should have repaired this, but I didn't, right? We have to be intentional. So today is a great day to start. Today's a great day to stop putting off your mindset. It's not as strong as you want it to be. It's not where you want it to be. That's not okay, but it can get better today. It can get stronger today, right? We talked about before that mindset is a muscle. And the more you work it out, the stronger it gets, right? You think like an Olympian, right? We've talked about it for the last few weeks. They've trained their muscles to respond in the moment, right? They can respond when the lights are on, when the whistle blows, when the game begins, because they have trained their muscles and their mind to respond in those situations. If they didn't train their muscles, they would get into that moment and it's not going to work out very well, right? Imagine standing on the starting line of the 400 relay or just a 400 race and that whistle blows. Now, one, you wouldn't be in the Olympics, right? If you hadn't trained your muscles, unless you qualified and then just did nothing for the next 6 weeks. That whistle blows, your muscles aren't going to be ready for that moment. You're not going to respond the way that you want to. Your body is not going to respond the way that you hoped it would because you didn't train it. You didn't prepare it. You didn't work for it. Well, the same thing is true for our mindset. If we want our mindset to be an asset in our difficult moments and in the moments where adversity hits, when we're facing obstacles, we have to work it out. We have to do the work to prepare our mindset so that we can operate in those moments. And again, it's difficult. It's not always fun to address the lies that are holding you back. I get like that can be some heavy work. That can be some deep work. We have to do it, right? We have to consider the alternative, right? You keep working around and ignoring and putting off dealing with those lies. Like that's not the life that you were meant for. That's going to hold you back. That's preventing peace. That's preventing freedom. That's preventing impact. That's preventing influence. That's preventing you from unlocking your potential. That's not what you want. I had a great conversation this morning with a guy. We were talking about changing behaviors for people. And in our behaviors, we're okay with them, right? Like I'm perfectly okay eating unhealthy food every day, right? I have no problem doing that. What will change us is seeing the impact of our behaviors. When I eat all that unhealthy food, I don't care. I look in the mirror, I see the impact. I go to the doctor, they tell me, hey, your heart is not operating well because you're eating terribly. Okay, now I see the impact. I see the cost of my behavior. Hey, you're on your phone all night while your kids are sitting next to you. I'm just fine being on my phone. I'm not okay with my kids thinking my phone matters more than they do. So what's the impact of your unhealthy behaviors when it comes to your mindset, right? Because you're just fine doing the things that you've always been doing when it comes to your mindset, but be honest with yourself about the reality and impact that you've created. Are you okay with that? What's it like to be on the other side of your unhealthy mindset? How's that impacting the decisions you make, the way that you work, your relationships, your health, your influence? How is that helping you overcome adversity, work through obstacles, deal with difficult situations? If you don't like it, it's time to change something about it. All right, so just like we're having to do with our house, you don't want to be rushing when it's too late, try to get these things done. Work on it now, right? Prepare for the moment so that you're prepared in the moment. Right? Do the work now to start dealing with the lies, to dealing with the unbelief, to dealing with the unhealthy mindset so that when you need it, your mindset is an asset for you, not a liability, that it's a strength for you and not a weakness. Tracy, any thoughts on any of that?
Yeah, lots of thoughts. I mean, I love seeing here that Leslie's saying that they're putting the deep work of fixing their mindset. I mean, not many people do that really. I mean, intentionally. And it does take intention. If you don't mind, I want to pull in one of our tools because it's so good. Because just this idea of being intentional is so good. And here it is. It's that mirror. I just love the visual of that mirror of you looking, me looking in a mirror back at myself going, okay, what's it feel like to be with Tracy Rader all day? Is she an intentional person? You know, and when it comes to mindset, there's so many enemies of a healthy mindset. And one for me is just pure busyness, well, I'll take care of that later. And it's what we do with our houses, right? It's like, well, I'll pick that up, or I'll organize that later. I'll get rid of some old junk some other time. And we don't, we put it off. And then it's time to move and you go, oh no, I've got so much. Yeah. Or, I've got a wonderful mother-in-law who's had to move, and she's now in a nursing home. And there's a lot of stuff that has been accumulated, and we all do it. And there's sweet, special memories, but at some point we have to kind of start taking things out. And she's had to condense her life into one room. And that takes some effort and intentionality. So,
yeah. I remember, I may have told the story on Monday Mindset at some point, but probably a year and a half, 2 years ago, you know, I went to the chiropractor, and cause like this shoulder, one of my shoulders was like an inch. I mean, it was way off, right? Completely out of alignment. And like, it was, when I went in, it was almost to the point of like being unfixable. He's like, man, you were just 6 months, maybe a year away of like needing like orthopedic surgery or something major. And I just put it off for so long, right? Like I knew that I was uncomfortable. Like I was constantly shifting in chairs and just always working around it, but I almost waited too long to where it was unfixable, right? It's like, that's just what we do. We just keep putting things off. Mm-hmm. And we do the same thing with our mindsets. Like we can't put it off or it's going to ultimately hurt us. And again, I know it can be uncomfortable work. It can be really difficult work. It can be exhausting work. We have to do it, right? There's power in showing up on purpose. And that means with your mindset. Like you just mentioned it, but we've said it on, I think, every single episode. Like, you have to be intentional with your mindset. Accidental is not going to cut it. You have to be intentional. And so what that looks like is doing the work when it's required, right? Doing the work that simply needs to be done. Right. Don't delay. Don't put it off. Don't make excuses. Don't work around it. Don't avoid it. Don't wait for somebody else. Like, you have to do the work of developing the right mindset, because I can't do it for you. Tracy can't do it for you. Your boss can't do it for you. Your spouse or partner or kids or nobody can do it for you. It's up to you. Like, your mindset is up to you. So stop delaying and start doing the work.
Yeah, for sure. And I would argue that our society right now, today, we might be in the hardest environment for a healthy mindset because of all that's being thrown at us through. And that's our choice to be on social media or always watching the news or whatever. So we really have to protect our minds like never before, I would say, and teach our children how to protect your mind and to gravitate and on purpose go toward things that are healthy instead of unhealthy and negative.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Got any questions coming in?
We don't have questions, more like comments of people going, yes, yes, I need to be intentional. So this was a great reminder today. It's always good to hear your perspective and what's going on in the real world.
And for those who are on the platform, you know, one, there's a series, I don't remember what it's called. It's not Building a Healthy Mindset. It's the other one. There's another series about mindset. It's just prompts for you to like work through. Highly recommend you just spend a little bit of time each day. I mean, these are like 5 minute prompts, no words. I mean, there's words on the screen, nobody talking. It's almost like guided, I don't want to say meditation because that'll make people think it's weird. It's not.
Yeah. It's called Mindset Matters. Mindset matters. Yeah. And it actually takes our tools and really partners them with your mindset. Like, how can you take one tool today and let it sink in and change the way you're thinking? It's really good.
Really, really powerful. Like, again, just watch one of those videos a day, kind of put that on your calendar, get that as part of your rhythm. It's a way for you. Part of the issue with our mindset is we don't create room for silence. We're just always busy and consuming. And that's a great way to create silence. Sharon, great question. Best way to start. I think it's sitting down and getting clear with, Tracy, can you pull up, I think the change equation kind of makes sense here. Mm-hmm. It's getting clear on like, what are you dissatisfied with as it relates to your mindset? It's acknowledging, right? Admitting there's a problem, for lack of better phrasing. But where are you dissatisfied with your mindset? What is your dissatisfaction? Like, I'm too negative. I'm too worried. I'm too stressed. I'm too fill in the blank. And then add to that, like, I'm too blank, which causes blank, right? Again, to realize the impact of that, your behavior is anxiety, your behavior is worry, your behavior is negativity, whatever it is, and realizing what that's causing relational issues, that's causing me to be able to disconnect, that's hurting my influence, or people don't trust me. And then going, okay, well, probably we've been working backwards saying, why are you, what's causing you to be negative? What's causing you to worry? What's the real issue there? But saying, if get clear on your dissatisfaction, but then have a vision, like what does you with a healthy mindset look like? If you were positive instead of negative, what would that look like? If you were confident instead of worried, what would that look like? If you were at peace instead of anxious, what would that look like? Getting clear on that vision of a healthy version of you, right? You with a healthy mindset. And then realizing like it's hard, right? You're not, that's going to sound overwhelming. Just like any goal can sound overwhelming. I'm not going to lose 30 pounds today. I'm not going to write a book today. I'm not going to climb a mountain today. You start, right? And so what's the one thing you can do to start moving forward? Again, maybe it's deciding to have a morning routine. Maybe it's deciding to watch one of those Mindset Matters videos. Maybe it's just having a conversation, you know. But what's the one thing to do to move you a little bit forward today? Again, you're not going to solve it. It's a process. So what's one thing you can do? And one thing I would add to that is finding someone to help you, right? Who can help you along the journey? Who may be on the same journey? Who's like, hey, I want to work on my mindset too. Great. Let's encourage each other. Let's challenge each other. Let's hold each other accountable. Because it's really hard to change alone. I've just found that to be true over and over in life. It's just hard. It's much easier when you have some level of community. And so who can help you within that? But I think the way to start is, again, get clear on why you want to start, right? Why are you dissatisfied? What could be, and then what's the natural next step?
Yeah, that's good. I was just thinking you need a partner, because for some reason we just can't see ourselves clearly from in us. It has to be like someone else sharing. So, I mean, if you're brave, you could ask your spouse or your best friend or who you live with, how would you describe my mindset? And does it affect you positively or negatively?
Yep.
I mean, if someone would actually tell you the truth, you could get a clearer perspective.
Yeah. I would say if you're really bold, ask all the key people in your life. And if you're married, ask your spouse or your partner, ask your boss. If you have a boss, ask someone you lead, ask peers, ask close friends, and put on your bulletproof vest. Maybe be prepared for some answers that could feel hurtful. But remind yourself, you asked for the truth, right? They're not attacking you. They're caring about you and say, you know what? Like, I love you, but you've gotten really negative, and here's what it feels like. Yeah. Okay. Again, they're not being mean to you. They're doing just what you asked. And so to be able to receive that with humility, say, okay, that hurts. They care enough to speak the truth. I need to get better. Right. And so I've made it a habit of having people in my life who have full permission to speak the truth. If I'm being a jerk, if I'm being a bad husband, if I'm whatever, like they get to call me up on those things, right? Same thing with mindset. If my energy, my experience, my attitude isn't what it should be, they have permission. And so give people permission to speak the truth to you in your life, because we think we know ourselves, and we preach all the time, know yourself to lead yourself. I just think there's a level, right? Like, as much as I think I know myself, I always need somebody else's perspective, right? It can never hurt to have somebody else's trusted perspective.
Absolutely. Yeah. My husband and I have a little, if I'm working on something, if he's like, if I've asked, and I usually have to ask and pull it out of him, but hey, am I doing this? You know, am I being negative, or am I, da, da, da? And he'll go, oh yeah, a little bit. And so then I'll say, hey, if we're ever out and about and I'm doing that, would you kind of like scratch right here or something, or, you know, some sign to go, Tracy, you're doing it. Stop that. Yep. But you have to have pretty high trust with somebody to be able to do that. And so some days I take it well, and some days not so well, but something as a reminder, because they're just, yeah, you just can't see yourself clearly from the inside. It's just very strange. So anyway, well, we're getting lots of just nice little, you know, reach outs that what you're saying is resonating. So like Christina is just saying, a great way to think about mindset, the fact that it, you know, an impact changes the perspective. Like, who are you impacting with your mindset? So that's so good, Kevin.
It always goes back to, right? It's like a leader mirror, like, what's it like to be on the other side of you? Oh, I don't want people to think that about me. Again, it's not worrying about what other people think. It's like, we have to be in charge of the experience people have when they're in our presence. It's like that mm-hmm. does matter. It's not their opinion, it's not their validation. But it's like, if they're having a bad experience, I don't want that. I don't want people to have a negative experience when I'm around. So I have to own that, have to change that.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much. And thanks for joining us. We had a lot of people today from Facebook and LinkedIn and the Giant Platform. Again, if you're watching and you don't yet have the free version of the Giant Platform, just go to giant.tv/culturewins. That connects you with Kevin. He's an expert in this. And so that way, if you want to put your team on the platform, I mean, this is something that you can do with your whole organization. Some of the things that he was mentioning, like the Mindset Matters series, is on there. You can get that for free. But then if you want to really immerse your team or your organization in what we're talking about, Kevin would love to be part of that with you. So as usual, thank you, Kevin. It's always a great way to start my Monday. We'll see all of you next Monday.
Have a good week.